terrifying ordeal. A co-pilot sucked halfway out a jetliner's cockpit window, 30,000 feet. The window shattered. The plane forced to make an emergency landing. He survived, and it comes a month after a passenger on a Southwest flight was partially pulled out of a broken window. Renee Marsh is out front.
Shocked passengers on board a Chinese airliner as oxygen masks dropped. It started when the windshield on the right side of the passenger plane's cockpit suddenly blew out.
We were eating. All of a sudden, we heard a bang, and then the plane began to go down. The duration of the drop was about 4 to 5 seconds. It was chaos. All the lights went out.
The Airbus A319 was 80 minutes into flight and was flying at an altitude of 30,000 feet when the windshield shattered and the co-pilot was sucked halfway out of the plane despite wearing a seatbelt. The pilot and flight crew were praised for the safe emergency landing in southern China. The co-pilot surprisingly suffered only scratches and a sprained wrist, and no passengers were hurt, according to local media.
You're going to look very carefully at the maintenance record of the aircraft. Had they done any work on the windscreens prior? Had they perhaps taken it out and replaced it because there was a crack in one of the layers?
Aircraft windshields are several layers thick. They're designed and tested to withstand air pressure at 400 knots and survive hitting a bird without catastrophic failure. But windshields occasionally crack, and the pilots land as soon as they can. But a bird strike at 30,000 feet is not likely.
If the windscreen is going to fail, it's at a lower altitude when it's hit by something. A bird, some other object strikes it, but they're designed to withstand that.
This scare comes nearly 1 month after a passenger on board a Southwest Airlines flight was killed when an engine on a Boeing 737 broke apart and shattered a passenger window. The female passenger was partially sucked out of the plane.
Well, the NTSB is still investigating that incident here in the U.S., but aviation experts do not believe that this is a sign of a larger problem with aircraft windows. Aaron, they point out these were two totally different aircrafts, a Boeing and an Airbus, and they believe that the cause of the accidents will likely have very different explanations. Aaron?
Certainly, of course.